Most businesses really do not make good use of their welcome page. So after somebody opted in for example, a checklist or a cheat sheet, what I really often see then is that they redirect people to a page that says like, hey, welcome, check your inbox in the next 5 to 10 minutes to get your download, and that's it. But I think if that's all you're doing, then you're really missing out because you have two really cool options. Option number one is that you use it as like a little survey page to figure out a little bit more about that person and why they opted in and what their biggest struggles are. And then option number two, and that's what we're going to talk about in this video, is the 15-minute opt-in upsell. So after somebody opted in, we show them a page with a limited time offer that is valid for 15 minutes. So in this video, I want to show the strategy behind it, and I also want to show how you can implement this on your own website. So let's start with the strategy first. So somewhere on your website, you have these opt-in forms, right? To get them onto your email list. So this may be in like a blog article, maybe you have dedicated landing pages, maybe you have exit intent pop-ups, all that good stuff to get their name and email address. Then after they fill this out, we want to redirect them to a welcome page. But instead of like a boring welcome page that says, welcome, check your inbox, we want to redirect these people to a page with a special limited time offer that is valid for 15 minutes only. So they have to make a decision really fast, right? And then there's also a button on that page where we redirect them to the checkout page. And also on the checkout page, we're going to repeat that same offer again. And on both of these pages, we're also going to show timers to show people how much time they have left to grab this offer. But we also want to make this offer authentic. So we want to make sure that when the deadline expired, that they cannot get this deal anymore. So to do that, we're going to use a tool called Deadline Funnel. And with Deadline Funnel, we can automatically redirect people to a different page when the deadline is expired. So what we're going to do is on the checkout page, if people land on the checkout page after the deadline expired, then we're going to send them to a page that says like, hey, sorry, the offer is expired. If you want, you can still grab it for the regular price. And what we want to do with the welcome page is we dynamically want to swap out the content on that page with just like a regular welcome text. So then instead of like a special offer and countdown timers, we just show a text that says like, hey, welcome. And we do this instead of redirecting, because people probably or maybe are going to download multiple downloads. And then if they're going to do that, we do not want to quickly redirect them every single time to a different page, because then there's some extra loading time. So I thought what's better to do here is that we just dynamically swap out this content by some different text. I will show you how to do that. So right now I'm logged into Deadline Funnel. And if you do not have an account yet and you want to support me, then you can use my affiliate link in the description below to create a free trial account. And then the first thing you want to do is you want to add the tracking code to your website. So this is the tracking code up here. Then we just copy it, and then you can do multiple ways. You can, for example, just add it to the header.php file, and then it'll just load everywhere on your website. Or what I personally like to do is I like to copy the code and then I manually add it to all the pages where I'm going to use dynamic timers, and also where I want to redirect people away from a page when the offer is expired, so after the deadline. So in this case, it's going to be our welcome page. So this is going to be the welcome page that I'm going to use. So it starts here with your checklist will be there in 15 minutes. In the meanwhile, read my short story below. Then I tell people a little bit about myself. And then in the PS section, I'm going to do the offer. So then this is going to be the text that people are going to see after the deadline. So then I just say like, hey, my email should be there any minute. This is how you can find the email, blah, 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 blah. But I'm not going to mention anything about an offer. But if the deadline is not expired yet, then I want to show this text over here. So let me read that real quick. So I don't believe in shortcuts that make your online business successful overnight, but I've put together a 12-page ebook that I think will make life a bit easier. It's about my 7 biggest learnings from the last 5 years that helped me tremendously to grow my online business. I'm usually selling it for $47, but you can grab it right now for $7 because you're new on the list. But only for the next XX minutes and XX seconds. After that, the offer expires automatically. Just smack the button below if you're interested. And then if they click this button, they're going over to this checkout page. And on this checkout page, I'm going to mention the offer again, and also again mention how many minutes and how many seconds they have left. And then also here in the sidebar, I also want to add an inline timer to make it even more visual when the deadline really is, right? Now, our tracking code. How do we add that? So it depends a bit on your website, but I can just go over here to edit page, and then I can add in my page builder a JavaScript block. So here, raw JavaScript, and then I can just paste the code in here. And then right now the deadline funnel tracking code is added to our welcome page. And then I will also add it to our checkout page. So here, raw JavaScript, go over here, save changes. And then now it's also added to the checkout page. Now then what we need to do after we added this to our important pages related to this offer is we need to create our campaign. So then the first thing we need to do is we have to give the campaign a name. So this is just for yourself. So I'm going to call this one opt-in offer. And then the category, what I like to do is I like to use the name of the product. So this is going to be entrepreneurial struggles. And as you saw, it's a 12-page ebook that does not really exist, by the way. It's just an example, right? Now then you also want to select your email provider and your landing page builder. So I'm going to use WordPress, but if you use something different, then that is no problem. Now then we're going over to next, and then we have to select a template. And then luckily for us, if we scroll down, you already find the 15-minute upsell over here. So here I click use template, and then you see that the deadline length will already be set to 15 minutes. And the time zone, what I would do is I would just set it to your own time zone, which is easy for reporting. And then if we go over to next, then we have our funnel steps, which are basically those same pages that I just showed you. So the important pages where we want to display timers and where we want to redirect people away from. So in this case, it's going to be my welcome page and the checkout page, right? So I'm going to do the welcome page first, and I just add this over here. And like I said, I do not want to redirect people away from this page, right? I just want to swap out this text by this text after the deadline. So the page just stays the same. So I will just leave this blank over here. And then I'm going to click finish, and then our campaign is created. Then we have to go over to pages. And then right now you see that by default, a floating bar will show up on this page that we just filled out. So if I refresh this page, then right now you see that we have this floating bar here in the bottom. Now, I'm personally not such a huge fan of it. So what I want to do is I want to personalize this text dynamically with the amount of seconds and minutes that are left. But before we do that, I first want to make sure that this text only shows up before the deadline and this text only shows up after the deadline. Now, luckily, that is rather easy to do. We can just edit this page, and then we have to add some CSS classes to those elements that you want to hide or show before or after the deadline. So in my case, I can do that like this. So this is the text I want to show after the deadline. So then what I can do over here, extra class name, I can type here deadline after. And now this text will only be shown after the deadline expired. And this is when I only want to show up before the deadline expires. So then I go to extra class name, and then over here I say deadline before. And also for the button, I also set that to deadline before, extra class name, save changes. And then we're going to update the page. And then I just want to check if that worked. So then we go over to the page. And then if I go down now, then you see that over here we have PS and only the PS with the limited time offer, not the other one. So as soon as this timer is going to reach zero, then this text will automatically be swapped out by the other text that doesn't mention anything about the offer at all, which is really great for a welcome page because often people also download multiple things. So if somebody is going to opt in now, they're going to see this offer over here. And if they're going to opt in tomorrow, then they will just see like a regular PS, so they don't see the same offer again. And because of that, the offer is also really authentic, right? We're not lying to people. We tell them like, hey, it's valid for the next 5 to 15 minutes. And that's also actually true. Now then, I want to hide this floating timer over here, and I want to make this dynamic. Now, so to do that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a new page, and then we're going to add the welcome page for a second time. So I'm going to add this over here, and then down here, I go here to display dynamic text timer. And then over here, you see the HTML code for the timer that we're going to need. So I'm going to copy this, then I'll save this over here, and then at the same time, I'm also going to delete that floating bar. So the floating bar, edit settings, then here the bin, yes, I want to sure. Then I go over here, and then right now you also see that the floating timer is gone, right? So now we only have to add that code over here. So I'm going to edit the page, and then I want to add an HTML block to this page. So over here, I'm going to say raw HTML. And then I will just paste this whole code in here, and also the extra class name, I already changed this to deadline before. Now then I'm going to drag this up here, and then I'm going to click update, and then I just want to see if the code is working at all, right? So then I go over here, go to the page, and then in the bottom now you see that it says here now, hey, deal is over in 0 days, 0 hours, 11 minutes and 47 seconds. So this is perfect, but we want to have it over there in that other text. So to do that, I'm going to copy this whole text. If I go over here to text, then I get the HTML of this actual text, and I'll delete this over here. I'm going to edit this, add this here at the top. And then over here, we have to look a bit. So here you see that we have span class for days, hours, and then over here we have it for minutes, and then over here for seconds. So here I'm going to remove this and then this. So we're going to delete this over here, span class, and then DFM stands for minutes, and then we'll replace this here, minutes, and then this for seconds. So DFS it says. So then I put that in here, and then I remove this and save changes, update, and then we're going to the page again to see what it looks like right now. So we have our page, we don't have a floating bar timer, but right now in here it says, but only for the next 10 minutes and 38 seconds. So I think this is awesome. But again, this is just an example, right? You can also do different things. I, for example, also saw people, they would then have here a title, some text, and then maybe a video where they talk about the limited time offer. So they would say, hey, welcome, your resource will be there in a few minutes, but hey, before you go, I have this like cool offer, blah, blah, blah. And then underneath that, they have like a button, something like that. But I don't want to be too salesy on this page. So I just have it over here. I don't think that's too pushy. And then here we have this dynamic text, which explains when that what the offer is and also when it expires, right? Now then we have still 10 minutes left basically. Now then, yes, I want the ebook. If people click on that, we go over here and we want to make sure that the deadline on this page is in sync with our welcome page, right? So to do that, it's pretty easy. We're just going to copy this over here. We're going back over to deadline funnel and we're going to add a new page again. So here I say okay. And then also, because it's a checkout page, and then if people still have it in their history, for example, and they would go back to this page, I really want to make sure that I redirect people away from this page when the deadline expires. So that's going to be this page over here, our offer expired page. And then down here, I'm going to dynamic text timer. So I'm going to use a dynamic text timer again. And then also here, automatically redirect to another page after the deadline expires. Leave blank if you don't want to redirect the page. So copy this. Click here save, and then right now also if the deadline is expires, we would already be redirected from this page, right? So I'm going to edit this now, and then I want to add that dynamic text up here. So I'm going to add a HTML block again. So here, raw HTML, I paste this in here, and then I'm going to copy this like I did before, right? So here, copy this, and then I say here, okay. Okay, so here we have paragraph, and now also one is paragraph centered, center, and then we do what we like, what we did before. So I'm going to add this, let me see, here, minutes over here, minutes, and then over here, this 2 seconds. And just to make sure that the code is also working, I'm also going to add this class over here to this paragraph. So then we have this over here. And then I'm going to click save changes. I will drag it up here. I will delete this one. We're going to click update and let's see what that looks like right now if it worked. So then we go over to the page, go to the page. And then right now you see that it says $7 instead of 47 for the next 7 minutes and 44 seconds. And if I go back over to this page, you see that if I refresh it still, it says this like same deadline. It's always in sync. It's really awesome that this is possible at all. And then I want to do one more thing on this page. I also want to show an inline timer over here because I think those are really pretty. So then I'm going to click here, add new page. Then we want to copy the checkout URL again. I want to paste this in here, and then over here we have display inline timer, and then after the deadline we want to redirect people to this page. So I will just put that in here. And then this is the code we're going to need for that inline timer. I click save. And then over here, under offer expires, I want to add HTML block with that inline timer. So then over here, we drag that here. And then I'm going to click update. And then let's see if that works. So then we go over here. And then right now you see that it says here, offer expires in 6 minutes, 44 seconds. Now over here, we have, for example, also have days. So I think, if I remember correctly, you can also say here, edit appearance. And then you can go over to settings. And then for example, we can say here, I want to hide the days. And I also want to hide the hours. So I'm going to click here, continue, save and exit. And then now if I'm going to refresh this, then you see that it just says really short, offer expires in minutes, seconds. And this is basically how you set up an opt-in upsell offer for a limited amount of time of 15 minutes. So some people, they're going to opt in and then they're going to come to this page. And then on this page in the PS section, I will tell them about the offer. And then over here, it says for the next 5 minutes and 28 seconds, 27 seconds, 26 seconds. And then if they go over here to the checkout page, then on the checkout page, we repeat the same offer with the same deadline and also the same deadline over here. And then if we're going to wait for a few minutes now, I will quickly forward the video. Then you can also see what happens after the deadline is expired. So you see now that we have about 19, 18, 17 seconds left. So also on the other page, it says here now, okay, 13 seconds, 12 seconds. And then I just want to show you what happens like when this is reaches zero, right? So we have 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And then boom, you see right away, it's going to redirect people to this page. And also if I'm going back to this page now, it's going to redirect people. There's no way for people to access that special offer anymore, which is really great. And then now on the My Story page, you see that dynamically without even having to refresh the page, now it says this over here, the whole special limited time offer is gone. Now, I hope that this helps and I hope it gives you some ideas to create your own limited time offer right after people are going to opt in. So let me know in the comments below if you're going to use this or not. And also, if you have any questions, just let me know in the comments as well.